Okay, in this video, I show Big D what wood owl bit to choose from. I was on the SedgeTool website, Taylor Toolworks, and I was trying to decide which wood owl bit I wanted. And there were so many choices, from the ultra smooth, to the nail chipper, to the one drive. So I got all three. I'll step you through, and Big D, in this video, the differences. Oh, and I almost forgot, there's plenty of links in the description for Taylor Toolworks. That's where you get wood owl bits.
All right, Sedge, what are we getting into today?
We are gonna talk about wood owl bits and the differences between a super smooth, a nail chipper, and an overdrive bit.
Oh.
And the reason I went out and got these bits is because I have been using a bit like this with this tri-flute for about 15 years. And I can't dull it, and it's 1 3/8. And I wanted to know the difference because I wanted to start buying some more for the Sedge Tool Shop.
Sounds good.
I finally figured it out, and I'll go through it with you. Okay, so I went out and got one of each. And I want to point out here that this is the one that I'm used to. And when you look at this, there's three flutes. And this is a self-feeding auger bit because it has the screw point. See it?
Mm-hmm.
Once you get it going, that will take you through the hole.
Gotcha.
Okay? That's what, hence self-feed. But I want you to notice these little spurs here, here, and here. Okay? And that will be on the front and back of the hole. And this is how we're going to test them. What does the entrance hole look like? What does the exit hole look like?
Okay,
and we'll make the judgment of that after we start cutting here in a few minutes. But this one is similar, or it's the exact same thing as that 1 3/8 I have back at work.
Okay.
Now, the next one, if we look at this, it's still a self-feed bit, okay? But you're gonna notice there's no spurs on here.
Oh.
This is the nail chipper, okay? In other words, if you encounter, see the three flutes? If you encounter something like a nail or a staple or something in the board, you stand a chance, like on this super smooth, of chipping or breaking that spur off.
Okay.
So we'll look at this and we'll see the results with this going in and coming out. The third one is quite unique. It isn't a self-feed bit. It's your typical auger. Okay, but if we look here, you're going to notice there's a certain like chamfer in here. Okay, and once again, if we look at the back of the shaft, this overdrive is designed for cordless drills. So we'll test it on a variety. I'm gonna use a cordless drill on all three of these.
Okay.
This has to take a 1/2-inch shank chuck. Okay, but we'll see and we'll do some testing and we'll go through it.
Sounds good. All right, Sedge, which one is this one?
Okay, that is the ultra smooth with the spur tips.
Okay.
All right, now we're going to look at the entrance of the hole and the exit of the hole.
Okay.
A quick qualifier, this is Southern Yellow Pine. Okay. I am going to have it in speed number 2. This may look familiar, but it's orange and black instead of green and blue.
Right.
I have a Festool battery because Pro Tool is an older version of the PDC hammer drill. And I want to look right here. I am going to go from 0 to 850.
Okay.
Just remember, the lower the spin, the more torque.
Okay.
Okay, when you do this, I want you to feel it as it pulls you through. I'm not going to put much pressure, and just pressure in the beginning, okay, to take me through.
All right.
So, I'm done talking. When you're using something like this, always use a handle. Because there's a lot of torque on this. And I have it in drill mode. Wow. Wow. Boy, wow. That took me right through. Look how smooth this is. We're also going to look at entrance, but look, see how it's shiny in there?
Yeah.
Look how smooth that is.
That's crazy.
Okay, Big D, now I want you to feel as it pulls it through, that little threaded tip.
All right.
Not a lot of pressure, just enough to... And there it goes. Wow. Okay, and let's look here. Okay. Look, barely any tear out.
Wow.
Okay, and Big D, as you do this, I want to look at that. Look, there's zero tear out. That's what those spur points do.
That's awesome.
Okay, I think right now I'm going to tell you that's a Chad Maker's dream bit right there. Okay, let's look on to the next one.
All right.
Okay, so here's the nail chipper, but let's look at it. I'm going to put it right here.
Okay.
Let's remember the way we're doing this. Still same spur point, still three flutes. This black coating on here is PTFE, polyfluorine tetraethylene. Wow, that's one heck of a long word. But what it does is it just keeps the bit cooler.
Gotcha.
And a smoother run. Wow. Okay, you try it.
Okay.
And it's going to be obvious. Smooth, a little coarser,
a little
right?
more aggressive, yeah.
Okay, a little more chip out here, but because you don't have those spur points. Go for
All
it.
All right, let's do it.
But still a great bit.
Okay.
Let's look at the back. A little more tear out. Okay, see how it's a little choppy mm-hmm. inside? But think about it. You're on a job site. That's the one I would probably take out on the job site because you might encounter those nails.
True.
Designed for cordless drills.
Mm-hmm.
They say in the marketing that I'll get more holes. But I want you to notice that's not a threaded tip. That is a spur point, but it's chamfered. It's designed to maximize how many holes you can get out of the battery.
Okay.
Now let's look at this. This is only two flutes. But it has a quarter inch. I'm going to quick change chuck there, so that can be a quick change between different size bits. Okay, let's check it out right here.
All right.
And see what we're doing. Wow. Holy moly, is that speedy. Cool. Okay, so Big D, I'm going to have you try it. And
okay.
Chris, come over here and get this. He's going to run it right through that knot. I want to see what that does.
Oh boy.
Cool. On something like that, you had to push it, right?
Yep, just a little bit.
Because it didn't pull you through, but that's okay. Let's look on here. Okay. Oh, wow. That's humming. I am really impressed with that. Overdrive bit, it's called.
Overdrive.
Okay, you got the chip out here on your nail chipper,
mm-hmm.
but it's still a little bit rougher in here, and that is, oh, God, that's like the perfect hole right there. So, Big D, what do you think?
I'll tell you what, the flutes on this bit make a big difference.
It does, and the spurs, right? That's the selfie that has the spurs right there,
yeah.
right? Okay, that's the one I'm going to choose for the Sedge Tool Shop. But this is great on a job site if
yep.
you encounter nails, but you're going to see here, you're going to see the chip out. And the one drive for cordless drills is amazing. That only has two flutes, but let's look at the other side here. And you're going to notice, boy, that one drive still has a lot less tear out. You're going to see it's rough inside,
mm-hmm.
okay? Where this one here, okay, that's your nail chipper. Boy, that has some tear out, but it's a great job site bit.
Right, very
That's the one I would choose out there, you know, drilling studs and everything. But, man, I am so impressed with this. And looking at the three different types on the Taylor Tool, website, I was really confused about it. So I called and Mike Taylor described them to me. So I just want to point that out. The link is out there. You could check in our comments, not comments, our description.
There you go.
We'll have a bunch of different links to Taylor Toolworks. So check it out.
All right. All right, Sedge, what's this?
Okay, so this is, and let's look at the end here. This is a bit brace adapter.
Okay.
For the bits. This goes in here. I think this is only available at Tay Tools. Okay, it locks it in, it centers in, okay, and it holds in here. But it goes in what is known as a bit brace. So a lot of chair makers will use a bit brace because it's nice and slow and they can get the angle a little bit better. It's for all the hand tool guys out
sure.
there. And you need a certain tip or end like this to slide in. And you see how it centers right in there like
yeah.
that? So there you go. And
wow.
that allows you to do this by hand.
Wow. Truly so cordless drill.
I will, and I'll also, yeah, it is a cordless drill. But I'll go through this because this is my pride and joy. This is a Miller Falls, and it's a ratcheting bit brace.
Oh.
So we'll go through this in another video.
Nice.
Cool?
Cool.
All right. So Big D, what do you think? Which ones are you going to get?
This one, every time.
The ultra smooth for the perfect entrance hole and exit hole. And you, it's because of that spur point up there. So, as we always wrap up these videos.
Be positive.
Stay sharp.
Wicked sharp.